Okay, so our team did IPFS on mobile. Mostly we just talked about problems that we all had. The general consensus was if you're trying to get IPFS running on mobile, your job just becomes circumventing what the operating system is trying to stop you from doing. So that's the sort of key takeaway there. Problems were kind of listed out as network connections, specifically through cellular connectivity and sort of different types of networks was a major problem for findability and DHT queries, limited resources, and the main thing is limited access to operating system resources. So the operating system on mobile generally just shuts your app off whenever it feels like it, as long as your app is not in the foreground. So you have to use the amount of time you have available, like this sort of thing, very wisely. And that's a tricky thing to do. So the other thing is many things that you ask the mobile operating system to do are really just sort of like requests or suggestions. May I please use some network time? You may or may not get it when you want it. So you have to be able to deal with that. So we came up with some solutions and we kind of broke it down into things we've tried, things we wish we had already, and then sort of path forward. So things we tried were reducing the number of overall go routines, because that's a limitation in terms of compute on mobile devices. Fewer overall connections. Quick transport was much more resilient to changing network types than other transports. And then trying to complete tasks in the background after a user has like backgrounded the app or something like that, just taking advantage of that time. What we would love was like, hey, it would have been nice if there was a native, libp2p implementation for each of the operating systems that we were writing for. This is sort of pie in the sky dream. And better local discovery in general would help with a lot of sort of app type interactions. But the plan is we sort of decided, well, let's kind of create a working group.